Hi guys, I'm Akash Raut and welcome to Akash Biology. And my sincere apology to all the viewers because I was not able to post videos for a week because my health condition was not good. But now you are welcome to the video of Platyhelminthes. So taking no more time, going on to the topic. So Platyhelminthes is the third phylum after Porifera, Coelenterata, not Protozoa, now it is included in the Monera. So after Porifera, Coelenterata, there comes the Platyhelminthes. So platy means what? So the term platy means flat. What? Platy means flat. Hel means worms. So it is a group of organisms, class of organisms which are commonly known as what? Flatworms. Flatworms. And who coined the term Platyhelminthes? That is none other than Gegenbaur. So Gegenbaur was the first biologist to coin the term what? Platyhelminthes. The number of species of Platyhelminthes ranges up to what? 13,000. What? 13,000. So now coming on to the general characters. So as it is a flatworm, so flatworm means what? They are soft and their body is dorsoventrally flattened, means it is flat on the what? So let's consider this is the front side, means this is the ventral and this one is what? Dorsal. So if we see, the both sides are flattened to each other, so their body is soft, dorsoventrally flattened. So first character means their body is soft, dorsoventrally flattened. Flattened. And body is leaf-like because the leaf is also flat. Second one is they are mainly parasites. What? They are mostly parasitic. What? Parasitic in forms. So in the parasitic forms, coming on to the habitat, what? They are either fresh water, means they are either aquatic or they are what? Terrestrial. So most of them are what? Aquatic form. What? Aquatic forms. So they may be fresh water or they may be what? Marine water. Or they may be terrestrial as well. What? Terrestrial as well. Or maybe terrestrial as well. Now coming on to another things. What? In the previous classes of organism, that is in the Porifera and Coelenterata, we have noticed they do not have a distinct head. But in this phylum, they do have a distinct head. So what is that is known as what? Cephalization starts over here. This is mainly asked in entrance examinations. What? Cephalization starts over here. So cephalization means what? A distinct head formation. What? Distinct head. Head means cephal and tail means caudal. So you can remember. So cephalization starts over here. Another thing, they are triploblastic animal. What? They are triploblastic. Means tri means three, blastic means germ layer. So they have three zones layer and it starts from what? The Coelenterata. So outermost is ectoderm, middle one is mesoderm and third one is the inner one is the endoderm. What? Endoderm. Another character, this which number? This is fourth number and this is fifth number. They have organ. What? They have distinct organ. So organ type of body organizations. Means the cells and cells are combined to form tissues and tissues are combined to form organs. But there is no system over here. So what organ type of body organization? Organizations. And they have a blind sac body plan. What? Blind sac body plan. I have told you earlier what is blind sac body plan. Means the body has only one opening. So one opening serves as both what? Mouth as well as anus. There's no distinct anus like as us. Our body is not blind sac body, our body is tube-like body plan. But it is a tube and tube has only one opening. So mouth will assist both for mouth or a single opening apertures, mouth as well as anus. Now another things, as they are, what they are parasites, mostly parasites. So why do parasites need appendages? Means their body have no appendages. So appendages are absent in this. So there is no distinct appendages over here. another things what so its body has an outer covering of epidermis what so body or the skin has outer epidermis and these things that we have to remember so it has three classifications Torberalia, Cestoda and Trematoda so in one of the that is Torberalia the epidermis is what soft syncytial means the multinucleated cells over here and is ciliated what is ciliated is in the case of what Torberalians so in the Torberalians the outer epidermis is soft syncytial and ciliated whereas in the case of Cestoda and the Trematoda the outer body wall is syncytial and non-ciliated and the non-ciliated bodies are combined to form what a non-ciliated covering and these non-ciliated covering are called what tegument that we have to remember so tegument is present in the case of what Cestoda and the Trematoda this is the thing that we have to remember again I will say so in the case of Platyhelminthes there are three Torberalians Cestoda and Trematoda that I will be dealing in my next lecture so it is body wall is soft and ciliated in the case of Torberalians means the planaria or dugesia whereas the fascicula hepatica or Cestoda anything the body is covering with what tegument and eighth number character so as we have seen their body has three coverings sorry for the inconvenience of the disturbing sounds and the crying baby but so the outer if we see the body wall this is the outer wall means epidermis middle mesenchymal tissue what middle mesenchymal tissue or the parenchymal tissue is known as what mesoderm and this inner one is known as what endoderm so what we can see in between the mesoderm and the endoderm or itself in the mesoderm there is no any cavity so the phylum is absent over here what phylum is absent in other words the Platyhelminthes are what acinomates because there is no any gap in the mesoderm or in the gap between the mesoderm or the endoderm I'll be dealing about only phylum what is true phylum what is false phylum what is size of phylum everything in one video so they are what acinomates another things there are various organs and tissue all the tissues and the organs are what embedded in what the mesoderm what mesoderm coming on to another thing that is here digestive system is incomplete as I have told you earlier because there is only blind sac body plan so there is only one thing that is mouth or distinct anus is absent even in the case of the parasite the digestive system is totally absent so in case of non-parasites digestive system is incomplete whereas in case of parasites it is totally absent it is incomplete because there is only mouth not anus and there is no skeleton in the body similarly there is no respiratory systems they both are lacking over here because there are only organ type of body plan so skeleton respiratory organs are absent now coming on to another things the most important the excretions and osmoregulations excretion means the process of what the throwing out or just evacuating the unwanted products from our body osmoregulation means the regulation of osmosis they both are what brought about by a special cell known as phlegm cell what phloem cells, and they are connected to another tubule system, that is the protonephridia. And phloem cells, the questions mainly asked, what is the difference between the phloem cell and the solenocytes? They both are what, excretory cells. So phloem cells are a bit elongated and devoid of blood supply. This is the main difference between the phloem cells and the solenocytes. So phloem cells are a bit more elongated and devoid of blood supply with respect to solenocytes. And what this means, the phloem cells are connected to a tubule system called the protonephridia. So let's make out a figure. So this is what we can see, they are all connected to our outermost system. So these all are known as what, phloem cells, and this is one what, protonephridia. So these are just collective units, what, collecting units, but their main secretion is evacuated in what, protonephridia. So the main excretory organ is protonephridia, because they all, from the waste products, from the individual body cells or the regulations of the osmosis, they are brought about by what, phloem cells. So individual for a particular cell or organs, the excretory organ is phloem cell, but their all secretion is drained into what, protonephridia. If we just make a section of the phloem cell, we will get the figure like this. My figure is not so good, so sorry for the inconvenience. So there's a tuft of ciliary tuft over here. These are what, globules. So we have cut down like this. So what we can see, there are various pseudopodia. These are very excretory globules, and they are what, discharged by exocytosis. This is ciliary tuft, and this is what, a tubule system. So this is all about what, phloem cells. So phloem cell is connected to protonephridia, and this is the structure of phloem cells. Now another thing that we have to know about system, most important. So nervous systems, where our brain is located in the brain. So same is the fate of what, platyhelminthes. So nervous system or the nervous tissue is concentrated in the brain. So let's, for instance, let's make out a figure like this. So in the head regions, what, there are two ganglia. What, ganglia? Ganglia means what, the collection of cell bodies outside central nervous system. So from there, what arises, two longitudinal cords. What, two longitudinal cords, and they are what, both are joined by transverse commissure. What, transverse commissure? So we can be asked in entrance examinations, so how many ganglia are present in the platyhelminthes? So there are two brain ganglia. What, two brain ganglia. And from the brain ganglia, what arises? Two longitudinal cords. And they are what, joined by what, transverse commissure. So everything is simple if you try to understand through figure, because the visualization power is always greater than the auditory power. Then coming on to the another thing, what, segmentation. So pseudo segmentation is present like this. If we see a body, so in the body outside, we can see what, this segmentation like this. So for an outer appearance, we can see what, there is segmentations, but this segmentation do not correspond to the internal segmentation. So what happens if this is like this, internal segmentations, so it will be what, true segmentations. But in the case, that is metameric segmentation, the case of Annelida. But in the case of platyhelminthes, there is only outer segmentation. means the outer segmentation will not correspond to the internal segmentation. So this is known as what? Pseudo-segmentation. Pseudo-segmentation. Or the pseudo-metamerism. What? Pseudo-metamerism. Another thing that we have to remember, they have body, there are many parasites, and they have to regenerate in more and more number. So their body is at a high level of regeneration power. What? High level of regeneration power. So whole body can develop from any part. What? Whole body can develop from a part that is being just cut out. So it is a form of asexual reproduction. What is a form of asexual reproduction for the Platyhelminthes? So their body has high regeneration power. High regeneration power. So it is a mode of what? Asexual reproduction. Reproduction. Another thing, they are what? Hermaphrodite. Hermaphrodite means, hermaphrodite means both the testes as well as the ovaries are present in the same organ. What? Same individual. So they are mainly what? Hermaphrodite. So testes and ovaries are present in the same body. But though they are present in the same body, there is no self-fertilization. Then what? Cross-fertilization. They will need another organism for the mating. So here is what? Cross-fertilization. Cross-fertilizations. Because the ovaries and the testes will mature at different times. That's why they will need another organism for the mating. This cross-fertilization that is in internal, what? So fertilization is cross-fertilization and internal type. There is absence of skeletons, as I have told you earlier. And lastly, in as they are parasites, so they need to stick to any part of our body. So their head contains what? Suckers. What? Scolex or suckers for attachment. What? For attachment. So the head may contain what? Suckers for attachment and blood sucking. Finally, coming on to another thing, that is the developmental process. What? Developmental process. So developmental process is indirect. What? Indirect. So why it is indirect means that directly products are no baby. This is what? Larva. What? There are various larva. Mainly you have to remember of the fasciola hepatica. What? Fasciola hepatica, that is of the liver flock. So what is the, so you can, so means there is a shedding of egg. So egg will form what? Myracidium. Myracidium. Questions mainly asked to, you have to focus on this. So myracidium will what? Enter a snail. What? A snail, the body of a snail. Now it will form what? Sporocyst. Sporocyst. Now sporocyst will form what? Radia. Then it will form sarcidia. And this will what? Leave the body of a sperm. Leave the body of a snail. Or it is insisted on the what? Herbivorous. And it will form what? Meta. Sarceria. And this is what ingested by sheep, and it will form adult in sheep. Again, adult sheep will shed egg in that. So what we can remember, if you remember the sequence, we can remember the larva. So this is first larva, second, third, fourth, fifth. So there are five larva in the case of what? Fasciola hepatica. So mainly asked in the entrance exams again. So first of all, if we there's, I will be dealing in detail about fasciola hepatica in my upcoming videos. So this adult sheep, it will, that has what? Well developed fasciola hepatica in it. It will shed the egg. So the egg will form myracidium on proper favorable conditions. Myracidium will what? Enter the snail. In the snail, it will form a sporocyst, then radia, then cerebria. It will leave the snail. On appropriate vegetation, it will form metasarcaria, and it will ingested by what? Sheep. and we all be just thinking what, why this sheep will ingest metastasis? It is many on the, any of the grasses or anything. And this is the five larvae, and another of the Tania psorium. There are other larvae as well. That is Cysticercus oncosphere. And is there anything remaining? And this is Hexanth. Hexanth. So this video is all about just the general characteristics of the Platyhelminthes. If this video is helpful to you, then please like and tap the subscribe button for more videos. And one important notice, as the date for the IOM and the BP cases is out, if you want me to make the crash course video in a sort that it will be good for you to revise in the final hours of the exam, so you can just drop your comment on my YouTube channel on the topic on which you want the video, and I will make it soon to make your just revision easy for you all. And all the best. Then pull up your horns for the upcoming exams and stay tuned and connected with Akash Biology on a Facebook page as Akash Biology. Thank you.